And now your weather with meteorologist Gino Recchia.
The hottest temperatures of the summer, and I guess it depends on what you're looking at. Meteorologically speaking, we've already begun summer, but astronomically, we still have about 15 more days before we hit that. But it certainly felt like the dog days of summer with these temperatures that were well into the 90s. And we did break a daily high temperature record in Green Bay, 95 today. Old record set back in 1934 was 93. Average 74. We were about 20 degrees above that for today, and it was warm air all across the Midwest, scorching between 20 to near 30 degrees above the normal, especially in parts of the Dakotas. And this warm air is going to be sticking around here just as we continue over the next 7 days. It won't be as extreme. We'll start to cool off a little bit, getting down into the mid-80s, and then eventually towards the end of the weekend into the lower to mid-80s. But still, at least for the next couple of days, it's going to be a toasty one. This morning, lots of sunshine out there, and thankfully, we did have a little breeze, and you could see how the trees were shaking as we went into the afternoon hours. That certainly did help with that heat, because you can only imagine if it's 95 when we have calm winds. I mean, you're just baking out in that sunshine. Might as well crack an egg on the asphalt and let it cook. As we go into the evening hours, it's pretty quiet, mostly clear skies. We continue with the clear skies overnight tonight as we have a low pressure that's well up to the north, an area of high pressure down to the east. And the strong high, we call it kind of a Bermuda high. When we see this pattern set up, we tend to see very warm air moving into the Midwest, and that's why we're dealing with this well above normal temperature trend, providing us with a southwest flow, bringing in more humidity and very warm and above average temperatures. As we go into the next couple of days, though, we will start to see some increase in clouds and also the chance of some showers and thunderstorms returning into the area. Tomorrow's going to be a mostly sunny day. And then as we get into Monday, that's when we start to see a little bit of that cloud cover increasing and a few pop-up showers and thunderstorms developing. Here we are, 3 o'clock in the afternoon on Monday. A couple pop-up isolated showers and thunderstorms are expected. Then as you get into Tuesday, it's going to be the same thing as well. As for temperatures, it's going to be another warm one. We're waking up into the lower to mid-70s, and by the afternoon, we're breaking out into the lower 90s. Lakeside airs will be just a little bit cooler. Lake breeze is expected to move in later in the evening hours. 83. It's after 10 o'clock and we are still at 83 degrees. South wind at 8 miles per hour in Appleton, 79. Still a steady wind out of the southwest at 10 miles per hour. We're going to keep that steady wind overnight tonight. We got temperatures upper 70s, lower to mid 80s with that wind flow moving in from the south. And with that, that's going to continue to bring in more humid air. We've got dew points right now, not terrible, but as you go into the next 7 days, especially and Monday into Tuesday, dew points getting into the upper 60s, low 70s. That's getting into that oppressive category and very humid out there. So for tonight, we cool off to 72. Southwest winds 10 to 15. Tomorrow, we'll get up to the lower 90s once again, mostly sunny skies throughout the area. But then we start to cool off a little bit as we go into the next 7 days, kind of a slow step downward. We'll start to cool off a little bit from the strong heat wave, but still above average as we go into the next 7 days. And it looks like from Monday through Saturday, we at least have a slight chance of some isolated thunderstorms, Kelsey.
Hot week ahead. Thanks, Gino.